Another woman. Yeah, how about you?
I'm really boring. I enjoy this.
That's your man? That's your love? Yes. So how often do you have sex with him? It's typical in America. People don't ever dare to say anything about their sex life, especially not in front of others. Okay, let me give you some. I went in Belgium to give a lecture for people my age. I was at that time 45, looking as hippie as I am. They were all in suits and very wealthy. It's the Lions Club. It's a bit like the, well, you know, Lions Club. It's a sort of rich man's club.
Freemasons.
Husband to wife, permanent hair, you know, silk blouses. And I brought this young boy with me as a sample. And the subject was the erogenous zones of men and women. So I spoke to the guy in a blue bikini, and I showed people this is the erogenous part of the man's necklace. So one woman there said, "Miss Hollander, the Flemish, can I use your boyfriend as a fantasy tonight with my husband?" I said, "Fantastic, yeah, go ahead." And I said, "Do you have to?" It's the man, right? So as I was talking to those people, they couldn't get a hotel. So I said, look, when I drove into this country, I saw one brothel after the other. They call them massage parlors. Cecilia, Susanna's, Diana's. So I said to the filthy rich guys, I said, who of you has ever been to a hooker? And they asked the question. And, no, not me. I said, who of you has ever had a hooker or had a cobra? I said, but how do those people survive? It's not the peasants in front of them. Nobody said anything. So I said, okay, it looks like you're all very happy. Are you happy yet? I said, it's French. Still nobody opened the mouth. I said, Edward Colton, are you content? One big guy gets up to me. Madam Hollander, we are rich and that's something. I said, I'm sorry, you're the biggest bunch of poor little rich kids I've ever come across. Then I said to the women, now who of you had a little young lover like my young lover? But you could see in their eyes, ooh, yeah, this is it. If it wasn't for him. But the amazing thing, nobody opened their mouths. However, when I went to the loo afterwards, there come the confessions. There come of course, I have the hairdresser from Gento, or I have the flower shop guy from the next village. And why don't they dare to confess? Because their husbands have so much money on stake that if they catch them having wives, fucking somebody else, they get a detective officer and they throw their asses out and they don't have to pay these huge alimonies. So I went to the bar where the guys were hanging out. If my wife finds out, they're going to sue us. So this is the hypocrisy of anywhere in the world, basically, but in particular of people who are wealthy and have something to hide. So I think none of you have much to hide. You may be wealthy, but you have not much to hide. So did you like the film, basically?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is the father and mother of one of the couples that were in the film. They're mentioned still, Scott and Ulrike, but they're cut out somehow. Because they changed the final cut so much and they made it so quick.
If I would
still
have known
it.
You'll get them in the next one.
Yeah, yeah, in the next version. Anyway, we hope that this film will win and that we actually can see this sometime in the real movies there, so you can tell your friends what to see. Or on television, and they probably cut out a few four-letter words. And I have a few more books left, and I really hate to go home with another box of books. So if you want, for $10, it's a nice book full of tips based on I've written for Penthouse for 35 years until they got sacked, until Bob DiCioni got sacked, and I got sacked. And the attention span of the average American seems to be at this moment that of a mosquito bite. But I used to write long, saucy, juicy stories and answers. Now they said we'll replace you by somebody who just writes up five lines. So those letters are some of the Penthouse letters I've had. And there's a lot of tips for women how to please men, and then one for men how to please men. But they usually know what to do. So let me go there. If you want, you can have get rid of some of my last copies. There's a lady. And if that, you're